Hello, I'm Liz Lumley of Finextra, and we're here at EBA Day in Helsinki. And today I'm speaking to Conny Dorrestijn and Mark Hartley, both of Clear2Pay. So we're going to talk a little bit about a report that you have out called Flavours of Fast. Now, what's up with that title?
Well, as a payments modernization company, we're obviously involved with projects around the world, and we stumbled across these immediate initiatives everywhere. And we saw commonalities and we saw huge differences. And as our clients embark on a future-proof technology infrastructure, we feel responsible and obliged to support them and to make the most of that. And so we started looking into these immediate payment initiatives, and instantly you already see that the names alone give the flavors. It's faster, near real-time, immediate. So the flavors are huge, and they often stem from either cultural or regional points of view, but also from the purpose of the initiative. So is the project meant to protect or open up the market for new entrants? Is it to embrace the unbanked? Is it to build a very robust payment infrastructure that helps the local economy compete on a global scale? So there were many factors that really told us you can't speak of a definition. There are many flavors of fast.
So if the report's really focusing on immediate payments, what's different about the report?
Yeah, we've looked at many papers and many studies that are being carried out at the moment. And what we felt compelled to was to, first of all, also really very much have an opinion and not just facts. And for that, you have to make comparisons. So we made comparisons across the countries. And we tried to sort of bring some balance in that perspective. We've probably covered more countries than most, not just the ones that are hot today, but we've also looked at the very early initiatives like the ones in Japan. And what we've done is we've larded it with interviews, and I think that's so important that we create a dialogue between existing clients who've been there, done that, who are now in the midst of making up their mind, like what am I going to do, who are in very early stages. And we actually came to the conclusion at the end that mere speed alone is not the key element, it's the innovation that matters. And that's why we created the Fast Payments Innovation Index, which we hopefully will continue to build on for the next few years.
So I'm going to move on to Mark, because you use the buzzword, favorite buzzword of the industry, innovation. So is innovation really the key to all these immediate payment projects?
I think the key to success, yeah. I mean, it's one thing having, as Conny says, something that moves money in real time or near real time, but it's a question of how it's going to be used and what it's going to be used for. So again, it's about customers' requirements and what they're doing. So there are some good examples in various parts of the world that we've looked at. We've got some examples of customers who are have rolled out immediate payments in Singapore, for example, and they had an unexpected volume of incoming payments because they were offering higher rates of interest on their savings accounts, which was a very good example of how the system helped them get new customers. And on the other side of it, we've had other things in the UK where innovation has been actually brought about by non-bank organisations. So payday loans companies, for example, have taken opportunity of the real-time system that was introduced in the UK. And more recently, we've seen the banks offer PayM, which is allowing us to transfer money from bank account to bank account using our mobile phone as a proxy. So what we wanted to do was look at how innovation layered on top of real-time or near real-time or whatever the definition of immediate payments is, how new services can be rolled out, and that's what the index is trying to do, to look at the innovation that's happening on top of it.
So you mentioned payday loans, and you mentioned, of course, PayM, which is the mobile person-to-person payment system in the UK. I mean, are those kind of the main case study examples of innovation in faster payments?
They're good examples, and I think there's more to come. I mean, that example of PayM is person-to-person payments. There's another initiative in the UK called Zap, which will allow organisations, or I should say customers, to pay for goods and services at online shopping stores, which has been the bastion of the card company. So that's creating competitive opportunities for banks and indeed for merchants and customers to get an alternative to either using your debit or your credit card.